too.
Yo, man, you know what this is, man. This is your favorite channel, man. This is CTB. This is Chant Up Boxing. I'm your boy, Jay Slay. What's up to him, man?
What's up, everybody?
Yo, while y'all watching the video, man, please do us a favor. Hit the thumbs up button. Most definitely, if you're hearing the sound of my voice right now, I don't know why in the world you're not subscribed to us, man. Please subscribe to our channel. We are a constantly growing channel. We're dropping more content consistently now. And we kind of want to get y'all feedback, man. So make sure you leave a comment in the comment section and give us some feedback on our videos. With that being said, yo, what's the topic for today, bro?
Let's talk about the rumor PBC fuckery that may be going on. And also what Tim Smith might have said, what Head said. Let's talk about both of them.
Let's chop it up, man. I'm not going to lie, man. I was disgusted, man. I was disgusted when I heard this. I was pissed off. I was a pissed off boxing fan yesterday when I heard this news. I wanted to do a video immediately after hearing it. But I waited, man. I said, I'm going to wait till my boy Mon's ready. And we're going to talk this up on today. So I waited. It's disrespectful, man. It was very disrespectful. From a real boxing fan perspective, it was really disrespectful for a PR rep for PBC to say the things that he said. So, what were some of the things that caught your attention? And was you as pissed off as I was when you heard him say those things?
Yeah, I didn't like it because I feel like he's bringing a negative outlook on the negotiation, because he's already going into negotiation. When you negotiating anything, you can't have a negative point of view because it makes the deal harder to be made. I mean, that's in life, that's in business, that's in boxing, anything. So for him to come out and say pretty much that Crawford is pretty much going to, you know, ask for too much money or outbid itself to the point that they're not going to be able to afford to make the fight because Crawford thinks he wants a certain amount of money. And it could be true. You don't know. But the part I don't like, you can't assume that. You got to sit him down, make an offer, and see what he says. You don't know what he may say. He may have a rebuttal. He may have a counter offer. Y'all may be the meet in between where both of y'all can be happy. You know, so for you to come out and just say Crawford is just he gonna want too much money, is we can't afford it, I don't like that. Because if you're coming in with that mindset before you start negotiating, it's already got you, you know, behind the eight ball. So that right there was the part that really stuck out to me.
I'm surprised the part that stuck out to you, man. The part that stuck out to me the most was the part that he said about boxing fans. The part where he said that boxing fans really don't want to watch this fight. But like I said, we said plenty of times on this show alone that me and you have been watching, waiting for this fight for almost 8 years now. Like, the average casual fan at least been waiting for this fight for at least 3 years, minimum at least three. So to say boxing fans really don't want to watch this fight after 3 years of online debating, after back and forth on price points and price splits and who will win, blase blase, it's kind of insulting to hear a PR rep from PBC to say that fans really don't want this fight. But then the icing on the cake was when he said that the fans that do want this fight won't pay for this fight. They'll scream this fight. That was beyond disrespectful, in my opinion, because the same people who are saying that the real boxing fans won't pay for this fight, they're streaming, are the same people who are giving you Thurman versus Barrios, the same people who made you pay for Tank versus Cruz. They're giving you bullshit ass pay-per-views on one hand, but and then on the other hand telling you that the real fight that you really want to see, oh, fans ain't gonna pay for that fight, they're gonna scream this fight. So that's the part that really made me a little red in the face a little bit, in my opinion. I mean, the Crawford talk is the Crawford talk. He's gonna say what he has to say to in best representation of his client. His client is Errol Spence. So he's gonna say whatever it takes to take the heat off Errol Spence. He's the PR rep, that's his job. That's what he get paid big bucks for. So the part he said about Crawford really didn't bother me much. It was kind of expected. But that's an old talking point, in my opinion. But speaking about that part, first of all, before that, I want to get your opinion on what he said about that. What you think about what I said about the real fans being non-spenders of the money or whatever?
I feel like he's not educated on the situation, because I feel like Terrence Crawford and Spence fight can do at least 700,000 pay-per-view buys easily. I think this is a fight that you have two fan bases. It's the perfect storm when you want a mega fight. When you have two fan bases that's been going at it for years, on opposite sides of the spectrum as far as who they're rooting for. Most of the time, when you have those type of situations in boxing, you have a mega fight. That's why you had a big fight with Tyson Fury and Wilder. You had a huge fight with Pacquiao and Mayweather because you had two different fan bases that were that wanted to see which fighter can win. I think it's the same thing with this fight. I think you have a side with Terrence Crawford and a side with Errol Spence. I think he wanted to go by the numbers of Terrence Crawford, and I think you can't do that. I know you want to agree with everything I say, what I'm about to say right now, but he's basing it on Terrence Crawford bad pay-per-view numbers, and he's saying that because of those bad pay-per-view numbers that him and Spence won't do as good as he think it's going to do because of the money that he's going to ask for. But what he fails to understand is, to me, this is my opinion, this is nobody, this is not Jay's opinion, is that I always say, I think I told him before, Terrence Crawford fans is 50-50. And what I mean by that is, you got people like Jay that are real Terrence Crawford fans. They love him because of how good he can fight in the ring. They root for him because of the boxer. You know what I'm saying? Because they think he the best in the world. And those people, they watch his fights when they come on TV. They buy his pay-per-views. They go to his events. But then I think that half of his fan base is my opinion, is LDBC, Wilder, Spence, and PBC haters. They really don't support Terrence Crawford. They just want to see him beat Errol Spence because they feel like it'll hurt the LDBC or hurt PBC. Because PBC, well, I don't care what nobody say, it's black-owned because Al Heyman's the head. And LDBC is a black ran media company or YouTubers that people can't stand. So they feel like when Wilder lose or Spence lose, it's going to destroy those two companies or whatever you want to consider, whatever you want to call them. So when Terrence Crawford fights, the 50% that's loyal fans, they buy the pay-per-view. But then the other 50%, they don't have interest to me in Crawford other fights. So sometimes his pay-per-view numbers don't show it because those guys are just streaming the fights. But the one thing that he's failing to understand, Tim Smith, is when Terrence Crawford fights Errol Spence, that other 50% is going to buy the pay-per-view because they want to see Errol Spence lose. Because they feel like PBC and LDBC is losing. I mean, the point blank. So I think he's looking at it the wrong way. I think everybody's going to buy that fight. I think it's the biggest fight in boxing. Maybe outside, we talked about it in our last video, maybe Joshua and Wilder, if it's built right, could be as big as that fight. But other than that, it's no bigger fight in boxing. That fight's going to easily get 700,000, 800,000 pay-per-views.